PCTV, and we're here at the EQT Children's Theater Festival, and I'm here with Pam. Can you tell me what you do, Pam?
Sure, I'm the director of the EQT Children's Theater Festival. It's a project of the Pittsburgh Cultural Trust. Mm-hmm. So my very fun job is to find all of the performances and artists for the Children's Festival.
Awesome. So when did the Children's Festival first start?
This is the 33rd edition of the festival, so it's been going on for a really long time.
Yeah.
Our founding artistic director, Moran Welch, was traveling the world looking for performers for our regular season, our subscription season, and she started discovering these children's festivals all over the world. Mm-hmm. And she wanted one in Pittsburgh, so she worked incredibly hard, and here we are 33 years later, mm-hmm. which is cool because now we're seeing second and third generations attending. You know, the kids grew up going, and then their grandmas and their moms, so it's very cool.
Yeah. What's the attendance like usually for these types of festivals?
The festival is really well attended. We draw over 25,000 people a year. About half of those come to a featured ticketed performance, which is a theater festival, so that's the heart and soul of the festival. Mm-hmm. And the other half come down to the cultural district just to enjoy all the free activities. There's over 50 free things to do in addition to the shows.
Awesome. And you mentioned that you bring a lot of performers and artists. So what makes you choose which performers and artists to come in?
So every year it's like putting together a puzzle because children, just like adults, are also different at every age, and every kid is unique. Mm-hmm. So we look for a lot of different things throughout the year. Some of it's movement oriented, some of it's comedy or circus, mm-hmm. Some of it's visual arts. So I try to have at least two performances for every age range. So there's shows for babies as young as 3 months old. All up to teenagers, and of course during the Children's Festival all adults are kids too.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and actually, can you tell me about this piece? This is really cool, but please elaborate on what's going on.
Yes, so this is every year, in addition to the theater shows, we try to do a really incredible outdoor installation piece.
Okay.
So behind us is an incredible maze created by Town and Concrete from France.
Wow.
And there's over 2,000 hula hoops in this structure. Mm-hmm. So last week they were here building for several days, and there's a path that the visitors can go through the maze, and so it's pretty to look at from the outside, as you can see, but then inside is super cool as well.
Wow, it's beautiful. Well, thank you for joining us, Pam. We really enjoyed having you.
Yes.